Fourth and 19, folks. They've got to have a play as time's ticking away because they've got to stay in this ball game. They've got to win. They come out lined up in the empty set. Three receivers to the right, two to the left. Defense looks like they're going to man up with no safety. This is the exact offensive matchup that they want. The best receiver lined up against the linebacker. Quarterback steps back to receive the ball 5 yards deep in the gun. He takes a snap, drops three steps. He plants his back foot. He's looking for an opening. There's a blitz coming off the edge. He steps up to avoid the rush. He's looking downfield. He's got the inside receiver making a cut. He's got a step on the linebacker. The quarterback has a beat on it. He lets the ball go. It's in the air. Receiver's out in front of the defender. He's got him beat. He's out in front racing for the ball. It's coming down. He cradles it at the 15. He's at the 10. 5. Touchdown. Unbelievable play.
Now, wait a minute. Of course it's believable. It's physics. Specifically, the differences between scalars and vectors. So, let's just see that replay.
Quarterback steps back to receive the ball 5 yards deep in the gun.
Stop. See, measurements are defined as two different quantities. Scalars are measurements with only numbers, and vectors are measurements with direction. For example, when that quarterback takes the snap, he's 5 yards away. But from where? Back from the line of scrimmage. So the 5 yards by itself is a scalar quantity. When you add a direction, like 5 yards deep, it becomes a vector quantity. 5 yards scalar, 5 yards deep vector. Okay, go ahead.
He takes a snap, drops three steps, he plants his back foot, he's looking for an opening. There's a blitz coming off the edge. He steps up to avoid the rush.
Whoa. Here's the difference between distance and displacement. Distance is a measurement without identifying where he moved. It's a scalar quantity. When the quarterback makes a three-step drop, he moves about 3 yards back. When he moves about another 3 yards forward when he steps up into the pocket. So that quarterback moves a total of 6 yards. That's a distance. That's a scalar. Now, displacement is a vector quantity, describing about how far out of place the object is. So the quarterback dropped back 3 yards and moved back forward 3 yards. He's in the exact same place where he started. So his displacement is 0 yards. Distance, 6 yards. Displacement, 0 yards. So let's look what happened next.
The quarterback has a beat on it. He lets the ball go. It's in the air. Receiver's out in front of the defender.
Stop. So here's speed and velocity. But let's just do one thing at a time. So speed is measurement without direction. It's a scalar quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. It's that object's speed, but with a direction of motion. So the receiver accelerates away, gaining both speed and distance. This takes the receiver 5 seconds to run those 50 yards. So his average speed in any given time is 10 yards per second. The linebacker tries to keep up, but his overall speed is slower. He only goes 35 yards in those 5 seconds. So his average speed is only 7 yards per second. They're both traveling in a forward direction, so their velocity is also positive. You can't go from resting to your peak speed immediately. You've got to build up to it. This is acceleration. At first, the linebacker can keep up with that receiver, but eventually the faster receiver pulls away. That's acceleration, the change in speed over time. Acceleration is a vector quantity. It describes the rate at which an object changes velocity. Like velocity, acceleration is a vector. It happens in a direction. So let's just look at that play just one more time.
Quarterback steps back to receive the ball 5 yards deep in the gun.
Vector.
He takes a snap, drops three steps. He plants his back foot. He's looking for an opening. There's a blitz coming off the edge. He steps up to avoid the rush.
Displacement.
He's got the inside receiver making a cut. He's got a step on the linebacker. The quarterback has a beat on it. He lets the ball go. It's in the air. Receiver's out in front of the defender.
Velocity.
He's got him beat. He's out in front racing for the ball. It's coming down. He cradles it at the 15. He's at the 10. 5.
Acceleration.
Touchdown. Unbelievable play. That was a great play as time expired, resulting in the touchdown and ultimately the win and pure effort.
And pure science.